In this last video on the immune system, we're going to talk about what happens when it doesn't function like it should. We're going to discuss immune disorders. So as we can see, it requires a lot of different cells functioning together for our immune system to work like it should. If that interplay of immune cells malfunctions, then problems in the immune response can result. These malfunctions of the immune system can run the gamut from mild annoyances to life-threatening conditions. And in fact, allergies, which is the first of these immune disorders that we'll talk about, also can run that range. Allergies are abnormal sensitivities to antigens in the environment. We call those antigens in the environment allergens. So keep in mind that all cells have antigens. All cells have these surface signature molecules. Some of those antigens identify the cell as being a pathogen, but some of them just identify the cell as not being self. Well, if our immune system thinks that some of these allergens are actually from disease-causing organisms, the immune response to the presence of that allergen gives us the symptoms we know as allergies. Now, the symptoms of an allergy. Always result from a two-stage reaction sequence. The very first exposure to that allergen triggers clonal selection. And that in and of itself is normal. That's fine. In fact, it's common for clonal selection to happen. Our body recognizes this allergen, but it doesn't cause major symptoms in our body. Now, the problem arises if those antibodies that were made during that process of clonal selection, if they attach to a mast cell, this is a white blood cell that's filled with the chemical message histamine. That means that the next time we encounter that same allergen, that mast cell is going to start releasing histamine. And if you recall, histamine was one of the triggering molecules for inflammation. If that histamine is released in our sinuses, this is what causes the sneezing and the watering eyes and the running nose. If this histamine is released on the surface of our skin, it could cause a rash or an irritation. If this histamine is released in the tissue surrounding our neck, swelling of that could result in a very dangerous form of allergic reaction known as anaphylactic shock. Now, a former student of mine shared this picture with me of an allergy test that he had done. With this allergy test, what they do is they take a pegboard and put a variety of different substances on each of those pegs and press that into the individual's back. Now, these aren't needles, these aren't injections, it's just having this substance come in contact with that individual's skin. And as you can see, he showed a severe reaction to several different types of allergens in this test. He had mentioned that for 5 minutes he couldn't touch or rub his back at all. And he said that was one of the longest 5 minutes of his life, just because it was so itchy. The inflammation that you see is the result of histamines being released in his skin. Anaphylactic shock is one of the most severe forms of allergic reactions, and it can be especially dangerous. This is because if swelling happens within the throat and it closes off the trachea, the individual could potentially suffocate. Now, one of the treatments for anaphylactic shock is the use of an injection of epinephrine or adrenaline, and these are known as EpiPens. So an injection of epinephrine can be used if an individual is having a severe allergic reaction. Now, why is that? Well, adrenaline or epinephrine, it is one of our fight or flight hormones. It tells our body that we are in danger and that we may need to run away or we may need to fight. And this, in essence, redirects body resources away from the immune system, away from the digestive system, and instead directs those resources to our muscles and to our senses and to our central nervous system. And so in that way, epinephrine will reduce or suppress the immune system, reducing the severity of that allergic reaction, at least until that individual can get medical help. And so it can actually slow or prevent the inflammation in the throat that could potentially lead to suffocation. The next immune disorder that I would like to discuss are autoimmune diseases. Now, when we look at how the body normally functions, normally it only reacts against foreign or non-self substances. In fact, this is one of the reasons why if an individual is going to receive a transplanted organ, screening is typically done to see how similar the signature molecules are between the donor and the patient. And even after that, the patient will be receiving immunosuppressant therapy just so their immune system doesn't reject these transplanted organs. Now, an autoimmune disease is when the immune system turns against the body's own molecules. Again, the prefix auto meaning self, it identifies self proteins as being foreign. And so for that reason, these autoimmune diseases, they will cause inflammation and they will cause pain and they will cause destruction of tissues and structures within the body because the immune system recognizes it as being foreign. Now, an autoimmune disease is different than an immunodeficiency disease. In immunodeficiency diseases, certain immune components are lacking. And so infections recur. Now, this may arise through inborn conditions, may be the result of a spontaneous mutation, or it could also be the result of certain diseases. We'll talk about a few diseases that may lead to immunodeficiency. The first of these is leukemia. Now, leukemia is a cancer of the white blood cell. Individuals with leukemia will have a higher than normal amount of white blood cells, but majority of these white blood cells will be non-functional. And one form of treatment for this disease is the destruction of the red bone marrow. Followed by replacement of those cells with ones provided by a donor. Now, the immune system is negatively impacted. By both the disease and the treatment. And so individuals with leukemia are in the process of having their leukemia treated. They are often immunocompromised or immunodeficient. AIDS is another condition in which an individual will be immunodeficient. AIDS is a worldwide epidemic that kills millions of people each year. HIV, the virus that causes AIDS, ends up attacking helper T cells. And by eliminating those helper T cells, this in turn cripples both the humoral immune response and cell-mediated immune response. This takes us to the end of our discussion of the immune system. The next system that we'll discuss is the endocrine system, or the chemical communication system of the body. See you in the next video.